Myself, Akshara Sharma, here, Faculty of Chemistry at MIT Trust Rep. Alright, so my subject is physics, and I'm here to discuss last minute tips for the following chapter. Today's topic is magnetic effect of electric current. Right, this is the second chapter of physics. Alright, so let's discuss the important terms in this chapter. First of all, the very first important term is the introduction of magnet. So, we will try to understand magnetism and properties of magnet. Then, characteristics of MFL. What is MFL? Magnetic field lines. Magnetic field of a bar magnet. Then, we will jump into magnetic field around a current carrying wire or conductor. Right hand thumb rule. Magnetic field due to a current in a circular loop. Further, solenoid, electromagnet, Fleming's left hand as well as right hand rule, electric motor and electric generator, difference between AC and DC, domestic electric circuits, and lastly, electric fuse. These are some important terms, or we can say content of the chapter. So, let's begin our journey and we are going to discuss those things in detail. The first one is magnetism. Any substance that attracts iron or iron-like objects is defined as magnet, and this phenomena is termed as magnetism, right? So, magnetism is basically the force of attraction of a magnet. Properties of magnet. So, a magnet shows different properties. The first one is every magnet has north and south pole. Like poles repel each other and unlike pole attract each other. A freely suspended magnet will align itself in a north-south direction, north facing towards the north of a magnet while south facing towards the south of a magnet. So, these were the properties of magnet. Moving further, characteristics of magnetic field lines or simply field lines. So, very first characteristic is field line arises from north pole and ended into south pole of a magnet, meaning the magnetic field line starts from north pole and they enters at south pole. They are closed curve. Third characteristic is no two magnetic field lines ever intersect each other. Why? Because if they intersect, a compass needle placed at the intersection must point two different directions at the same time, which is practically not possible or which is impossible, right? Next characteristic is direction of magnetic field lines inside the magnet is from south to north. One more characteristic could be possible here, which is magnetic field lines is a vector quantity, right? So, characteristics of magnetic field line is important topic. One marker or two marker question can be asked from this topic. Okay. Further, magnetic field around a current carrying wire. So, this can be explained by using a compass needle. As it is clear, we can see it here in the diagram that we have considered taken a wire. That wire is basically connected to a battery key, and the direction of electric current is represented here. When we bring a compass needle near the wire carrying current, we will notice some deflection in the needle of a compass, which will direct or which will guide towards the direction of magnetic field. So, I have considered here two diagrams which ultimately represents the magnetic field around a current carrying wire. By keeping that compass at different points around the wire, the magnetic field could be explained easily, right? Moving next, right hand thumb rule. It is the important rule. Reason, this rule will be used to explain the direction of magnetic field lines around a wire, right? So, the rule says when you wrap your right hand around a straight current carrying conductor such that the thumb point in the direction of current. In that case, the fingers will wrap around the conductor in the direction of field lines of the wire or the direction of field lines. What is the meaning of this statement? If you hold a straight current carrying conductor in your right hand in such a way that the thumb points towards the direction of current, then the curling of finger would represent the direction of magnetic field lines. Mark it as important, right? Okay. Next is our magnetic field due to a current in a circular loop. As we can say, we have a wire. In that conductor, the current is flowing through one direction to another, and we have just bent the conductor or the wire in the form of a circular loop, which is quite clear with the diagram, right? So in this case, by using the right hand rule or right hand thumb rule, we can predict the direction of magnetic field lines nearby the conductor. In the upper part of conductor, as it is quite clear that when we hold the small portion of wire, as is considering it as a straight, we could get the direction of magnetic field. So current in the loop is into the paper, meaning the current inside the loop is inside the paper, representing magnetic field lines, whereas in the downward, the current in the loop is out of the plane. Some properties of magnetic field due to a current in a circular loop, which are explained as follows. Number one, the magnetic field lines are near circular at the points where the current enters or leaves the cardboard, right? So magnetic field lines are circular loops when it enters or leaves. Within the space enclosed by the coil, the field lines are in the same direction. Third, near the center of coil, the magnetic lines are almost parallel to each other. Thus, magnetic field near the center of the coil may be considered uniform. Right, students? So, one important question can be asked from this, that draw the magnetic field line in a current carrying circular loop, part 1. Part 2 of the question, also mark the points where the magnetic field is minimum and the magnetic field is maximum. So as it is quite clear with our concepts that at the two extreme ends of the wire where we have considered the circular loop, right? So the center of concentric circle, both the centers represent minimum magnetic field, while at the center of circular loop, which is the coincident center, or we can assume that it is the center is assumed at that point, since magnetic field lines are parallel, they are in the same direction. So as we know already that magnetic field is a vector quantity, hence both the field lines will add on. As a result, the maximum magnetic field will be at the point of circular loop, whereas minimum magnetic field will be at the two extreme corners, right? I'm sure this is clear. Moving to the next, which is a solenoid. First of all, what is a solenoid and how the strength of a solenoid can be altered or changed, or draw the diagram of a solenoid? Such type of questions can be asked from this topic. Okay, let's discuss solenoid in detail. It is a coil of many turns of an insulated copper wire closely wound in the shape of a tight spring. Basically, we can take a wire which is wounded in the form of a helical or spring tightly around the insulated copper wire, right? So the magnetic field of a solenoid is similar to that of a bar magnet. Once we connect the solenoid with the battery, it start behaving like the bar magnet, right? So the diagram of a bar magnet or a solenoid can be asked. Practice it well or practice it clearly, right? Moving to, and one more important question from this before we move to the next slide, that how the strength of magnet of a solenoid can be altered or changed. So in order to change the strength of a magnetic field of a solenoid, we can alter the following factors. Number one, when we increase the number of turns of a solenoid, it ultimately increases the magnetic field of a solenoid, right? Second point, by keeping a better magnetic, by keeping a better wire, or by keeping the turns very close to each other, in such manner we can increase the magnetic field strength. When we change the polarity of the battery connected to a solenoid, the magnetic field will also change, or the direction of magnetic field will be reversed, right? So that's it from the solenoid. Not anything extra from the solenoid can be asked in your coming exams, right? Okay, further important concepts are what is an electromagnet, and then we will jump towards Fleming's left hand rule, or similarly you can explain Fleming's right hand rule, right? So let's define electromagnet. It is a temporary magnet that can be easily demagnetized, right? In this type of magnet, the polarity can be reversed and the strength can be varied as per our need. These are very strong magnets. So if we are asked to prepare an electromagnet, how we can prepare it? By taking a solenoid, we can just connect the solenoid to a battery. The moment you switch on the circuit, you will notice that there is a magnetic field generated around the wire, and that magnetic field, since it is generated because of electricity, so we termed it as electromagnet, right? So the magnet generated by the use of electricity is known as electromagnet. Fine. Next is our Fleming's left hand rule. So how to explain Fleming's left hand rule? Basically, in your exam, the direct question will be asked based on this concept. Fine. So if we hold a straight current carrying conductor in our left hand, then the Fleming's left hand rule can be predicted. How? Stretch the thumb, the forefinger and middle finger of left hand mutually perpendicular to each other, such that the index finger is in the direction of magnetic field, middle finger is in the direction of current, then the thumb would point in the direction of motion or the force experienced, right? So students, if we hold a wire in our left hand in such a way that each finger is perpendicular to each other, in that case, if the index finger point in the direction of magnetic field, middle finger is in the direction of current, then the thumb would point the direction of motion of the conductor or force experienced. One thing you need to notice here, that Fleming's left hand is used exclusively for electric motor, right? And I'm not taking these two topics, electric motor or generator, in this presentation. That you can refer to our glossary. Okay, so let's move ahead. Domestic electric circuit. The one marker question can be asked, which type of wire is red in color, or what is the color of neutral wire, and so on and so forth. So I'm sure you must have noticed this nearby your surroundings or in your domestic, in your home, that the three type of wire can be used in domestic circuit. Number one, a live wire, which is coated with red color. Number two is neutral wire, which is coated with black color. It is basically the neutral in nature. And third one is earth wire. Earth wire is green in color, and its width is, or radius of earth wire, is more than the rest of the two wire. And the potential difference, what we already know, that the potential difference between live wire and neutral wire is, of course, 220 volt, which is Indian standard mark, right? So that is all about domestic electric circuit. Sometimes a question can be asked that draw the diagram of domestic electric circuit for two bedroom or three bedroom that you can draw easily if you know the basics of electricity. Fine. The last topic is electric fuse. What is the electric fuse? Why it is used? And what is the material with which it is made up of? Okay. So electric fuse is basically a safety device which is used to limit the current in an electric circuit. It prevents the electric appliances from damage. It is made up of material which has a very high resistivity and a very low melting point. Ideally, it is made up of an alloy of copper and tin, but sometimes it can also be used electric fuse made up of copper can also be used. So electric fuse is a safety device. It has to be connected in series with the circuit and it has very low melting point, right? So these are some concepts or the quick revision notes of important from magnetic field of electric current. Finally, let's discuss the type of questions. So again, the same here it remains. Question can be of one mark, which can be MCQ, value based, or one liner. Second, two marker question can be possible. Three marker question can be possible. And as you know, there is no five mark direct question. If it is a five marker, it is the merge of or the clubbing of two or three concepts, right? So some examples are I have taken here. Write and write any two points or two properties shown by magnet. Or write the two uses of electromagnet. Two marker, draw the diagram of magnetic field lines around a circular loop. And or further question can be possible, state Fleming's left hand rule. So refer the concept of magnetism for solving these type of questions. A three marker question can be, what is the electromagnetic induction? State two points to alter this or to change it. Draw the diagram of electric motor and write its principle. Differentiate between AC and DC. What is AC? Alternating current, and DC is direct current. Again, the hint is use the concepts of magnetism, right? The points to remember or the most common mistakes what we usually notice during the examination. Students forget to mark direction of magnetic field lines, or in some cases students get confused in Fleming's left hand as well as right hand rule. So prepare these two very well. Next, some doubts, some students gets confused in bar magnet as well as in circular loop. So prepare this concept also in a particular manner. Finally, student get confused in color coding of the wire used in domestic circuits, which I have already considered in this presentation. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope this video will help you a lot. Good luck for your exams.